And now the announcement I know I've been waiting to make, because I've been working on this for a long time. The newest edition of the NWO. And Bret Hart, what? Because you were such a knockout kind of guy.
Eric Bischoff drops the Bret Hart bomb on WCW. Hello, everyone. I'm Scott Hudson. He's the living legend, Larry Zbysko. This is WCW Pro on TBS. Two words, legend, Bret Hart.
Well, you know, seeing that the announcement came from Eric Bischoff, and we have to remember the source, I mean, here's a guy that needs a ladder to kiss a snake's behind. So I don't really buy that Bret Hart, being the kind of man he is, being the kind of athlete he is going to be a member of the New World Order. I'll believe it when I see it.
If Bret Hart has joined the NWO, that's another nail in the coffin of Sting. We saw on Monday Nitro Sting drop the bat and have the bomb dropped on him too.
Yeah, we got to realize World War III is coming up fast. The New World Order will do anything they can to eliminate any key players. You know, Lex Luger, the Giant. I mean, what if Lex Luger winds up with the Giant? The NWO is doing all they can to end it beforehand.
Ray Traylor is standing by on the Pro.
Tell you before we get started here, Scott, the Abomination, the New World Order pulled off against Sting once he dropped that bat. Tells me how desperate they're getting to clear the field of top players for World War III.
No question about that. We're going to take an in-depth look at what happened to Sting. But what about what happened to this man, Ray Traylor, on the most recent WCW Monday Nitro?
Well, I tell you, this guy Traylor, he's been spray-painted more times than a New York subway.
Ray Traylor was annihilated by Randy Macho Man Savage, three top rope elbow drops, and then painted the ultimate insult when Liz grabs the spray paint can from backstage, hustles back to the ring, and paints the NWO across Ray Traylor. What an insult.
They're desperate men.
Well, she's a desperate woman.
Look.
Like anybody confuses her for a man. No question about it. Mark Kyle and Ray Traylor starting us off on the Pro. 1 week away from World War III on pay-per-view. And let you know, all weekend long, I have been running through the what-if scenarios in my head. I know you've been doing the same thing. What if it ends up with Sting and Lex Luger? What if Sting is in World War III and it ends up with Sting and Lex Luger as the last two participants?
Well, could wind up Lex Luger the Giant. Could wind up the Giant and Rey Mysterio Jr. And the combinations are endless. What we don't want to see is it winding up Lex Luger or Sting or the Giant or anybody against three or four members of the New World Order.
Well, that's exactly what happened 1 year ago at World War III when it ended up being Lex Luger versus four members of the New World Order, and he almost won it. Almost went through the entire NWO to get the shot at the title. He did not win it, but this year you got to have Lex Luger, an odds-on favorite to come out on top of World War III.
Yeah, well, the odds-on favorites like that usually don't make it because everybody groups up to get rid of the man they think, you know, is the biggest threat. That's why I'm thinking, you know, a Malenko, a Rey Mysterio, even a guy like Eddie Guerrero who can move at the speed of light may survive.
It's a lot of cardiovascular training too, legend. All the weights in the world won't help you when you got to go 20, 30 minutes with 59 other men in that ring.
You know, the only thing you've got to guard against is the unity of the New World Order.
Well, there are other units that we have to concern ourselves with. What about Raven's flock? This just ragtag bunch of misfits continues to grow every week with the debut last Monday Nitro of Hammer. Add that to Sick Boy and Kidman and Saturn and Raven himself, and you've got a unit unto themselves that could be a potent force at World War III.
Yeah, and there could be a unit that no one's, you know, really paying much attention to, and that is a group of luchadors that may have gotten into World War III. It's going to be definitely a situation, you know, where no one's going to know what happens to you, see? I mean, it's just too hard to predict.
That's coming up 1 week from tonight on pay-per-view at World War III. Call your cable company or satellite provider. We'll be in Auburn Hills, Michigan, and you can join us on pay-per-view. Ray Traylor into the ropes. Mark Kyle draped over the center rope right across the throat. Drapes him underarm and throat first across the middle rope.
I tell you, Ray, he knows how to use his weight. Look at, he slips right underneath. Ooh. Big man moves like a lightweight, and Kyle didn't even see that coming.
Big right hand from Ray Traylor just rocked Kyle. Knocked him off the ropes right back into the center of the ring. There's the high sign from Ray Traylor. This is an angry man after what happened to him on WCW Monday Nitro. Whoa, hang on. Kyle sets him. Looked like the Russian leg sweep. Reversal and escape by Traylor. Oh! Sidewalk slam, the Bubba slam from Ray Traylor, and the three count. Impressive victory. Fighting his way back up after Monday Nitro, Ray Traylor gets the win on the pro.
Yeah, Kyle went for that Russian leg sweep, but he just didn't have the hook. He didn't have the leverage. And Big Ray here, he blocked the move and turned it into a nice reversal.
The NWO better keep eyes in the back of their head for this man, Ray Traylor.